Hey, what's going on, guys? Obviously, I'm still feeling the Philly sports mojo after our Super Bowl victory, so I'm trusting the process. Hopefully, the Sixers will make the playoffs, and still super jacked up about the Eagles winning the Super Bowl. Anyway, I'm really excited to show you guys a video for something that I've been meaning to do for a really long time and finally figured out how to make it happen, which was to program InDigital Performer to control my rig so I don't have to do any tap dancing live anymore. I just have everything programmed to just run. It's controlled through Midi. I've got a Midi adapter from USB. It goes into my Triaxis. From my Triaxis, it sends the Midi signals from the through port into my G system, and that controls my whole rig. So I've got everything programmed in DP. So if I'm, especially if you're doing like a tapping line or something, there's a lot of times where it's really challenging to be playing something that's, you know, spread out on the neck, and then try to, you know, make your patch changes. Can be really challenging, and then you end up playing wrong notes and making a mistake that you wouldn't do necessarily otherwise. So I'm really excited about this, not to mention it means I finally got all my like delays and other effects that are time-based to be set at the correct tempo or BPM of our song. So my, you know, delays are now gonna delay in a quarter at the actual tempo of the tune. I think it's gonna really help with the kind of last little bit of spit and polish. We're playing a gig at the Pharmacy on the 9th of February 2018, playing with a couple of local bands. I'm really excited. We're at the main stage for that one. I just got the advance. I'm gonna get all the information and events out soon. And we're also playing, opening up for Intervals and for Jason Richardson on the Monday after that. I think it's the 19th. At the Fillmore, at the Foundry at the Fillmore, and I can't believe we're lucky enough to get this gig. So that's kind of the other reason why I'm going through all this trouble right now. I want to get my stuff dialed in so we play, you know, as good as possible, or at least I play as good as possible. So let me show you guys how I got this going on. All right, so welcome to my digital performer project file. I'll show you guys exactly how I have this set up to control my rig. First thing you're going to need, though, is a USB to MIDI adapter. So all this little thing does is take a USB port and turn it into a MIDI port. This particular one has a MIDI out and a MIDI in jack on the end. That's what the split part is. And what happens is that way, if you need to back up your rig, so I have both of my Triaxis and G system backed up project file wise. That way, if I get to a gig and something went wrong, let's say like the battery inside one of them died or whatever that saves your data, you don't lose it. I can back it up quickly. And then the other reason is that then this can then turn that USB port basically into a MIDI port, and then I can plug that into my rig and control it. So like I said in the video, the way that I've got it, it goes out of the computer into the Triaxis, uses the Triaxis through MIDI port to go into the G system. The reason why I didn't go G system into the Triaxis is that the G system's out port will not resend an incoming MIDI port. You need a MIDI through for that, and unfortunately the G system only has ins and outs. So there's not a way to have it go G system into the Triaxis, which is normally how my rig is set up. So it's a little tricky in that if this stops working live, I won't be able to control my rig. I'm a little nervous about that, but I think the benefit of being able to have the computer play it or control my rig is gonna be well worth the trouble. So into the actual software now. The first thing you're gonna have to do is create a MIDI track. So this is my MIDI track right here. I have it called Rig Control. And what you have to be able to do is be able to control which bank it's going to select. So in Digital Performer, the way that you have to do that is I go to the Insert tab, and it has a whole bunch of different controllers by default. One modulation, two breath, blah, blah, blah. These are all different MIDI channels. And it doesn't actually default to any zero controller. So in the G system, the zero controller is the one that controls the bank that you're selecting. So what I had to do is just go to other controller first, then tell it to create controller zero, and then I have the ability to control which user bank I'm in. The way that you do that is then I just enter the data, just one data point on that controller zero, and the data point needs to be a one. So if you make that a one, it'll automatically select your user bank that you need. From there, in DP, it's extremely easy. All I do is go to Insert, Patch Change, and then as I drop those in there, I'm not gonna actually do it right now, obviously, these little blocks show up, and there are the patch change blocks. And it's really easy. You just insert one of those, and then in here, you just select whichever patch you want to pull up. In this case, I'm on patch 8, which is my like main rhythm guitar tone, you know, kind of high gain, aggressive guitar tone. I've got, I think I'm up to about 25 patches that I've made so far. And basically, you just drop it on in there. And the cool thing is you can have it trigger wherever you want. In this case, I put it on a 16th note subdivision so that my patch will change. It'll pull it up just before we drop in the beginning of this tune. Then as it plays, it will just select the different patches. So I'm on the same patch for a little while. And then over here, I've got a spot where I just want it to go to like a low gain tone, and it'll just automatically pull it up for me. And like I said, as it goes, it'll just make those patch changes for me. So it's really easy to drop it in there. It didn't take long at all. I think the most time consuming part is really just creating the patches in the rig ahead of time. So I'm gonna cut to a different little clip, and I'm gonna have it just sort of play and have you guys watch it just kind of select the different patches.
All right, so here we go.